as human. Doesn't matter what continent you're from, or what your fealty is, or your beliefs are. When you have one person that is trained to kill 110 people, whether it be from the age of 3 or 16, you can't sustain that. You can't produce enough to sustain that kind of ecology. You just can't. Not unless you do it on a global scale. And by that time, it's a one world government. Two steps away from World War, okay? World War III, whether it goes to nukes, whatever, doesn't matter. We all live, we all die. There's only two facets that affect those things. That's when, okay, three things. When, where, and how. We all die. That's inevitable. We're human. We're not gods. We're not omnipotent. We all die. When, where, and how. Make your choice. I personally will not be attacked with impunity. You attack me, I'm going to fight. And I have the means to take out 300 people. Well, technically I have the means to take out 80,000. Abilities, yeah, 300. That's about the most I can do. means. America's a little bit different. Each person has the ability to make their own rockets, their own explosives, their own firearms, their own ammo, and the resources are readily available to everybody. We don't have to rely on ingenuity, we rely on knowledge. We know that aviation fuel, kerosene, burns slower, but it burns efficient. We know that gasoline burns faster and hotter than kerosene, but it's more explosive. Diesel, on the other hand, the higher the compression, the higher compression after a certain point becomes more efficient than gas and kerosene. However, the byproducts are poisonous. Because it begins to create PTFEs and noxious fumes that are hazardous to humans. We have a lot of swamps in the United States, especially in some of our biggest cities. You think we don't know how to use those resources to poison an invasion? We've been studying that shit for almost 100 years, maybe even 200. I'm nobody's enemy until they attack me. You invade my country, you're gonna die. Or at least as many of you that invade my country as I can take out. Partially the exception to the rule. 21 weapons per person in my household, with 2,500 rounds per weapon. Do the math. Seriously, do the fucking math. Attack my country. See what happens. And that doesn't even include my ability with bows and traps and snares and that kind of thing. Deadfall traps, blah, blah, blah. And by no means, I am a less than average American. First commander that I'll meet, I will take out 30 of his soldiers 14 hand to hand. Barehanded. Maybe with a combat knife. And I'm just one insignificant American. So bring it. However, for those of you that are Chinese or Asian descent, I mean you no ill will, unless you follow your leader with blind faith. If you do that, you will have no mercy from me. And you invade my country, I will be as brutal as I have to be. I will give you no quarter, and I will not recognize your honor. However, you fight me with honor and integrity, I will give that to you in kind. However, the next invader, at best, will only be able to take half the United States. And that's the western half. And it's the least populated part of the United States anyway. It has the least amount of resources, the least amount of farming, the least amount of usable ground. Which means that the war that's impending is an ideological one. Okay, I might die, but I will take as many of you fuckers with me as I can. Me, that's a coward's way out. That's dishonorable. I've put out the challenge. Meet me face to face. Fuck you. If you don't, you're a coward. You want to talk about honor, ethics, and integrity and all that crap? China's nothing but a fucking coward. Never's been anything different. Now, don't get me wrong. The citizens of China were a lot different than their leaders. I understand the difference. The differences is I learned very early in my life the difference between propaganda, truth, and reality. My grandfather fought in World War II. He hates Japanese. Because their ideology. However, the Japanese adjusted their ideology and they started to understand things in a different light without changing culture. That's not bad. That's not a negative. The Japanese attacked the United States directly. I have no fought the British and the French. We had heavy losses, but we won. The next war is going to be no different. No matter who starts it or who invades, it'll take a little bit of time. Will wipe out any nation, any country, or any ideological behavior that is contrary to American views eventually. Even with the infighting that we have in our own federal government. I realize most of the government that we have is bought and paid for by China. Okay, I get that. That's well understood from my perspective. Attack our mainland. I may die. But I will take as many fuckers that dared to attack the United States out as I can. And I'm not in the military. I'm a civilian. And I'm not afraid to die. The invasion is going to happen. Yeah, I do. You'll understand. Take out 12 by gunfire. I will take out another 14 in hand-to-hand combat in front of the commander. And then I'll attack the commander, and then I'll die. But my quota was reached. I'll kill 32 people of the invading army, or whatever it is, before I die. Less than average American. Do the math, figure it out. Yeah, you might have the numbers. You may be brutal. You may not adhere to the Geneva Convention. Invade my country. Watch what happens. It's only a matter of time. USP or whatever. But this has been shit.